Hello, I am Maud and welcome on Women Run the World podcast. The show where you can listen to unique interviews of female runners that I met during my run trip world from 2015 to 2017. You will listen to interviews with no filter to understand why women are running, how it's different to run in Cambodia, Kenya or Brazil. Let's go and meet all these women who run the world. Welcome on number 27 of Women Run the World podcast with Te interview. She was an ultra runner running long distance. One of the first women that I met who was participating to races above 100 kilometers. For Te, women were equal as men, not only in running, but also in life. As I told you in the last episode, female Malaysian runners have a different way of living than other Asian countries. So you will see that Te has a similar way of thinking as European runners. Let's listen to Te's story.
Hello.
Hello.
Tell me who you are.
And yeah, I'm Te Xiangxi. I'm 37 years old. I'm from Penang, Malaysia.
Tell me when you start to run.
When I'm a teenager, I like to play balls. I like sport a lot. And then after that, after graduate, start working and I stop all sports and concentrate in working, try to find more monies. And now after a few years, I myself feel that I'm fat, and I think why I cannot continue my sport. But because of my last time I'm playing volleyball, so if I want to gathering all the members come back to play balls, then my friends all still working, and then they have families, so they are unable to get me together and play balls. So myself think that I think I can do some sport that do it alone, so I choose running.
And could you tell me how running changed your life?
Changed my life? I will join I'm joining a few ultra marathon. 50 kilometer and 100 kilometer. And then my next year, 18 March of 2016, I will join another 200 kilometer Selangor. Titi 200 kilometer.
So running help you to push your limit?
No. Last time, when I see some elderly, they can run a full marathon 42 and 195 kilometers. I say, how come the elderly can do? Why not me? See, I only run 10K, 21K, and I feel exhausted and I feel very tired. But sometimes I see they can finish it within 7 hours or 6 hours. I think myself can do it too. So I'm pushing myself to do further and run more, train more. I think women also can do it. What? Not only men can do, but women, I can do ultra also. What? Is it not only men can run for 50K, 100K? I think women also can. I have my own target. I hope that I can go others country to join others ultra marathon too.
Do you know Ultra Trail du Mont Blanc? The big one, 160K?
Yeah, this one is 100 miles. Is it? Yeah. Yeah, but right now they have two different. One is the trail run, one is the only tar road, 100K, and different. They are totally different. So myself now still training for both, half. And myself, because I don't know whether which one is I suitable for me. Now I'm still learning how to do, how to choose, how to run. Yeah.
And you talk about men and women, and so do you think it's hard to be a woman in Malaysia to run?
No, I think a lot of athletes are women, very good. They are really awesome. They are really can run faster and do better than a man. I not only Malaysia, I think all the women in the world. Yeah, very, they can, they got women, they can take care of their children, they can do own business, they can also have their own time to like me and myself can do own business, take care of my families and do my own exercise and training.
So do you have children?
Yeah.
How many children?
Only one.
Only one. How old?
6 years old.
So how do you combine to train and to be a mom?
I will send her to school, then and come back to do my business. I will do my own business. And then I will arrange around evening time, I do my own training.
Good. And do you have a coach?
No.
So you train on your own?
Maybe I will ask some advice from friends. Maybe because different body, different training method. Sometimes you can ask some experienced runner. You can collect their experience. So we combine together. Then we can do which one is the suitable us for training.
Could you tell me one of your best memory about running?
Best memories. But that one is bad memory. I think I joined Taiwan Marathon 2 years ago, and then I got food poisoning, and I totally cannot run. And then I.